Remember that Toyota ad, Roads Schmodes? Well, this week, we put that to the test. We set out this week to conquer Taylor Pass, which would push both the limits of our vehicles as well as our driving and spotting skills.
They're coming down. There you go. Okay, hold up.
Stay tuned as we navigate through the technical and demanding trails of the Colorado Rockies, working hard, laughing lots, and creating memories to last a lifetime.
Yeah, bro.
Woohoo!
She's all clean. It's time to go get her dirty.
Every summer since 2017, we had gone on some form of epic adventure with the part-time Overland crew. Normally, this crew consisted of my best friend Nico and our longtime friend and photographer Yannick. This year was special, however, as we were joined not only by Nico's girlfriend Rachel, but also their two trail dogs, Kobe and Paco. As we would only have 1 week on the road together, I wanted to make the most of our time. We had planned to tackle some of Colorado's most technical and diverse trails, including Taylor Pass and the infamous Schofield Pass. First up, Taylor Pass, located right above Aspen, Colorado.
Hey guys, we are up here in beautiful Aspen, Colorado, and this week is gonna be a little bit different. It's not just me this time. This week we have an entire crew going on the trails. This is our resident Californian, Yannick. How you doing?
Good.
This is Nico.
Oh, I saw.
And I don't know who she is. We just kind of picked her up on the road. Right now we're at the trailhead, getting the trucks aired down. Well, Nico is because I'm filming. We got an awesome week planned ahead of us, so I think without further ado, it's time to hit the trails.
The trail took no time in letting us know who was in charge, as we wound our way up the side of the mountain, climbing over 3,000 feet in just a few short miles.
We made it to the first summit, and it is so gorgeous up here. Got a whole cloud layer, and there's a couple just peaks that the sun is shining through, and it's awesome. That being said, though, it is a bit cold. I would say almost down in the 40s or something. So we're layering up, trucks are holding strong, the dogs are having a blast. And the best part is, we haven't even made it to the official trail. So far, it's just basically been a dirt road, just on a ski slope, and the best is yet to come.
That is so funny.
Running across our first dilemma, which is that we started late and there's not a lot of great options for camping. We're kind of skirting along the top of a ridge right now, and we'll be doing so for the majority of tomorrow as well. So we're discussing some options. We're all hungry. We're gonna keep pushing a little bit further, and main thing, get food in the belly and then hopefully find a good place to sleep. I think we'll make it work.
With our camping options limited on the ridge, we decided to stop for a short break and refuel ourselves with a quick dinner. Though the night was approaching swiftly, we trekked on towards Taylor Lake, where we would spend the night and be ready for a long day of wheeling the following morning.
It's 6:45 in the morning, we're at 11,000 feet, let's go for a swim.
Good morning, guys, and it is a beautiful one. It is so gorgeous, and I'm kind of torn on night wheeling. I normally don't like it because you can't see the scenery, but the big thing I love about it is you pull up to a campsite like this, have no idea what you're in, and then you wake up to these amazing vistas, and it seriously is. We're almost at the top. I think we're still at about 11,500 feet. Air's thin, but it's beautiful. Sun came up this morning. Yannick and I already went for a swim, and I'm feeling good. Today is going to be the first day of official wheeling. Right now we're at the top of Taylor Pass, and the plan is to make it all the way down into Crested Butte via Taylor Pass. I think most people actually start from that side and climb up, which is technically a bit harder because you're coming up the rocks instead of kind of coasting down. Regardless, we got some pretty technical terrain to get over, so it's going to be a fun day of wheeling. So I went against my main rule on the trail, which is always pay attention. We've gotten ourselves in a bit of a situation here. That's there and it's coming up on my diff. So I think I'm gonna try to back up and pick a better line.
Straight, straighten out. All right, rocks up.
Only a few minutes of moving rocks and we were back on the trail. Though it seemed like a minor holdup at the time, this was only a small foreshadowing of what the rest of the trail would have in store for us. This is where things started to get tricky. While I had taken the main trail, Nico decided to go for a slightly harder line. Between my poor judgment on spacing and a tight section of rock, it was soon apparent that Nico's longer wheelbase was going to make for some challenging lines on these tight Colorado trails.
Okay, hold up. Yeah, this is the exact same thing that was happening earlier. These rocks are kind of
in here, bro.
All over the place.
Got ourselves in a little bit of dilemma here. This soil seems to be a bit softer than we're hoping for. Tiny bit more.
I'm clear. Tiny bit more. Stop.
We're realizing our situation is one of those where the more we try to get unstuck, the more we get stuck. We're going to try to dig out first. Winching is always an option, but I think it's more a last resort thing. I'd have to bring my truck back up. We'll try the digging, see how it works. Ultimately, we could totally get out, but it's just a matter of trying not to damage the vehicles, especially this early on in the trip.
Hold up. Here. Come forward slowly. Hold it there.
We made progress, but slowly. Very, very slowly.
Hold up. Crank hard. Hard fast.
You're climbing? Okay, and you're gonna drop. You're gonna drop in 3, 2, 1 now. You're coming down slowly. Yeah, you're through.
Good job, dude.
When you were young,
that took way too long.
Yeah, I did.
We took these first few hiccups as a wake-up call that this trail needed all hands on board. And with that in mind, we were able to clear the next several obstacles without a hitch.
Okay, your front is clear. Okay, your passenger rear is clear.
feet probably, you know? Just straight towards me. Okay, you drop over here, you're down, and max tracks. Okay, there you go.
We're coming to a section in the trail that is pushing our capabilities. I think it's totally possible we're gonna make it through, but comparing this to Pearl Pass, which I've done before, I was not expecting this. I'll show you here in a second. There's massive boulders, and then it actually drops down into a river for, it looks, about 1,000 feet, which is awesome. It's super cool, but definitely technical on the higher end of, I think, what we're capable of with our rigs. So the trail, we're up there. There's a bunch of lines, but none of them look good. We're thinking maybe come down the middle here, and then this literally goes down into a full-on river for about 1,000 feet, winds through the forest that way. It's all doable, but it's definitely tricky. I guess we'll see what we can do here.
Now began the slow descent towards the river. Up until this point, I had been fairly confident about the trail, but now I was beginning to have second thoughts. Trails like this start to cross the border between a fun off-road adventure and straight up rock crawling. My general rule for trails is that I'm willing to do anything so long as it won't do damage to the vehicles. This trail was definitely starting to cross that threshold. Okay, we're dropping. Oh, yeah.
Yep, this is looking really good. I'll go middle passenger.
Passenger?
One sec. Yeah, keep it coming.
Just a couple more feet, and we would be through the hardest part of the trail. Then into the river. One vehicle through, now on to the next. Though we would have to contend with the Taco's longer wheelbase, I was pretty confident we could make it through without a scratch. Just like that, both vehicles were through safely. After a short stop for lunch and a much needed debrief, we continued down the trail, following the river for what seemed like a mile or so. There were still a few sections of boulders to navigate, but generally the going was easy, and it may well have been one of the coolest sections of trail I've ever done. Finally, we were back on the road again. We still had plenty of time before dark, but it was a long day, and the next would be just as demanding. So we settled down for the night, cooked up some burgers, and enjoyed the sunset, looking back up the valley which we had just conquered hours before.
Who was sleeping by my side? What did I do last night? Can someone make this headache away? Yesterday.
Join us next time for more epic adventures as we conquer the infamous Schofield Pass and Crystal Mill Trails. If you've enjoyed the content on this channel, consider supporting us by becoming a patron. As always, my name is Carter, and I'll see you next time on the trails.